Hello? Okay, it works. Okay.
Hello?
Now I got an echo. But my music doesn't work. Maybe they muted me? I wonder. Probably did something weird, knowing my luck. Yep, still not working. Interesting. It's going through it now. That's so weird. Yeah, that's okay. Apparently, the music works now is inputting my music from my headphones into the stream instead of actually doing it the other way around, but I guess it works. You can hear me okay, right, Messina? Hopefully. Or you ran. Because my mic was probably horrible, horrible. Let's see here. Let's try to kill this guy. Trying to get my mount to tier 5. So I'm basically leveling right now my the tier 3 horse, the last one I needed to get to level 10, I believe. I have to ch double check that. Market, time to sell this. Wait, what's the lowest? 18. Okay. Let's sell it. Can I put it even lower? That's the question. Wait, the item just disappeared. What? Oh, I guess I did put it up. Weird. Still waiting for these two things to sell. I'm hoping this Scarlet necklace will sell. Do, 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 do. My dead? Oh, almost. No, run! Run! I hate when the mobs come at you from all directions. That's how you end up dead. Especially at these higher difficulties. It's best to just cone them in, and then you're like, "Woo! Murder." trying to get to that next threshold of 3,000 base CP, so I can have that extra invasion when I dodge stuff, because that's going to help a lot in arena as well as against bosses. Ooh, he still hit me. Ooh, that hurt. Oh, no dodge. Oh, I almost died right there. Oh crap. I hate when I'm on my last bar and you gotta make sure you dodge perfectly, otherwise you end up dead. Like right there. Ooh. I don't want to jinx myself. I'm going to play a little bit safer. Because on this difficulty, it could be just a simple one mistake and you're dead against these bosses. Like this. Oh, dodged most of it. Or like that. Ooh. Is the horse level 10 yet? I like using boss rushes to basically power level my horses. No, still a 9. For some reason, that the 9th level, that takes forever to get it to 10. It's really weird. Cyberpunk 2020. Lost Ark. Resident Evil 3, if it does come out next year. What else we got that's like, oh, so they're really looking forward to? Oh. No, it's not. Oh, it's coming out. They just finished hiring people for American like West Side of developers and stuff like that to actually help with releasing it. Eh, it could be, but you never know. Phantasy Star Online is coming out with English version of it. And I actually did get a VPN and a Japanese Korean account and played it, and I did enjoy Phantasy Star Online 2 a lot. I know I got towards end game and everything, but it's kind of hard to, once you start to get like at very top of the end game in that game, it's kind of hard when your ping is like 500 versus everybody else being like under 100. So. So those are like a couple of games. New World from Amazon. I actually alpha tested that game, and it's not bad. There's some things they said they're gonna improve on and change, but it's a pretty good looking game. I can show you in 1 second after I'm not being slaughtered by this lovely little boss right here. Oh, I don't think Rami saw my dance move. As far as I know. And usually happens when I'm tired. I'll start dancing when I'm tired or sleepy. It's for some reason that gets the blood going through me. And I don't feel as tired. Okay, there we go. It's dead. And I'm a little bit happier. No, it's okay. So I don't know why, and my friends noticed this, and I didn't think about it until my friends, my real life friends, start pointing this out. Every time when it comes around between 10 o'clock and 12 o'clock, for some reason my body is so tired, I just want to sleep, like sleep. If I work my way through it, I'll just like I can be awake after that for hours. But for some reason, my body really wants to go to sleep between 10 and 12 o'clock. But this is my gear. This is what I currently have. I'm currently working towards getting these two last pieces of armor to plus 25 to hit the next level of the threshold. But yeah, this is currently my gear. I have 30 crit chance. I have 18.74 attack speed. Almost 19% movement speed, and my owl is 30% out of 40, and my Ahibi is 27 out of 40. I think so. I think it's my sleep wall. Yeah, I totally agree. But yeah, I get sleepy. So what I do during that time between 10 and 12 to keep myself going, if there's nobody talking to me, because talking keeps me awake. If there's nobody talking to me in chat and Twitch, I'm going to start dancing. And the reason I'm going to start dancing, because this is how I keep myself awake. And I'll keep going. And I'll just go with the beat. Go with the beat. Go with the beat. So. And I have no shame. I won't twerk, but I have no shame of dancing while sitting. I would say yes. I would say this is the best mobile MMORPG, hands down. The amount of content. The biggest thing I would say that is a number one thing that I love as a mobile game. The cash shop doesn't get thrown in your face 24/7. And it's just not just a money grab. It's pretty good. I had a lot of stuff done. Like, I had this stuff at, like, 100, that character, ecology, and topography, I had it at 100. And I had these other ones a little bit higher, too, but since Medea came out, I gotta redo a lot of stuff. I wouldn't say so. Get crazy shit. I don't know. I actually, I had 800 black. I actually had 800. Was it black pearls? And the Nerity earrings basically dropped from my accessory. I also gotten two belts, and yeah, I also gotten this Nerity necklace, and I also got a scarlet necklace, and I had over 2,000 black pearls in my account when those dropped in the accessory shop. The new hammer, I wouldn't say it's rigged. You just gotta time it correctly. Because I managed to get the rewards I wanted. But other times, the problem is that if you complete one line, and if you want to hold on to that board to attempt other lines on that reward, you gotta pay 400 black pearls. It's not worth it. Do not waste your 400 black pearls. Just refresh your page and just go to the next one. And just wait. If you can wait, just wait. It's not worth 400 pearls to keep that page, to keep going at something. Unless this is like, we're talking about like a crazy item. Go for it. I don't mind. You can link, you can do anything you want in my chat. I am the most chilled back person you'll ever see. And I have no idea how to make that. Can I give you like permissions or something? You know what? Send it to me in private message and I'll link it in my chat. I think that's gonna be an easier way around it. Just send it to me privately in Twitch and I'll link it in the chat, because I have no idea how to give you permissions to actually not see three stars when I'm looking at a link. Because all I see is three stars in the chat. Horse is still level 9. Back to bus rushes. There you go. But I believe it. I mean, when you have no black pearls, you get some good stuff. Actually, believe it or not, Fox Biddy, I have one archer, and I think she's only like between level 40, 45. I'm hardly ever on my alt. Sinners, on the other hand, he's definitely grinding his alts. Me, on the other hand, I'm hardly on my alt. I've been farming mostly. I've been grinding mostly. Everything I have here, other than the rings and one of the belts that I gotten to get to +3 and the bracelet, everything else has either dropped for me. And these two helmets, the helmet and the glove, I actually bought it. The Grinnell stuff, I bought it, but I did manage to have the other gold items I had before this. And the orange actually dropped for me, so I was really happy about that. Yay, first orange is a chest piece. So I was like, yes, yes, yes. And my family was looking at me weird because this was on Christmas Eve and I'm freaking out. They're like, what's wrong with you? And I'll be like, I was like, you wouldn't understand. Nobody in my family plays video games. It's really awkward. I'm gonna die. I just know I'm gonna die now. Oh, I'm gonna die. Rigged. This is rigged. Oh, I'm dead. I'm so dead. I'm so dead. Oh my god. I'm so dead. This is rigged. This is so rigged. Leave me alone, Toad. I can't even... I can't even get a break. Oh, I'm dead. I'm so dead this time. Nope, still alive. Somehow. Yeah, there we go. I died. Honestly, yeah. What he said. I'm going to retry on a lower difficulty. Money is definitely the easiest way. Especially like with the whole year thing going on right now, where you get a double, you get black pearls now with the whole 30 bucks, you get 30 bucks in black pearls. That is crazy. But honestly, you can also get lucky. It's basically the accessory shop. Definitely the accessory shop. So it's sort of like a pyramid thing. As long as you don't waste your black pearls, like for stupid things, like for example the hammers, like the hammer events that we have right now, as long as you don't waste your black pearls and stuff like that, and if you focus your black pearls just to be used on jewelry and jewelry alone, you're never gonna lose money on that, because as you save up all your black pearls from all the dailies, from all the quests and everything like that, you'll finally be able to buy, you know, the necklace, be it purple or blue or gold and stuff like that. And then later on, you can sell it. Sure, you lose about 30% of it as a profit, but you'll still get most of it back. And because you get most of it back, you're always going to get ahead. You're slowly always going to get ahead. Now, sometimes you're going to get lucky. Sometimes you're gonna get lucky where you're gonna get a golden necklace from accessory add-on, and then I would advise you every single time, anytime you get a golden accessory and it's a black pearl and you can afford it, buy it, because then you can literally sell it back, just minus the 30% of what it's asking you to buy it for, and sell it back on a marketplace, and you're still gonna make some kind of profit, like, you know, 10, 20, 30%. Now, if it's something you want to, you know, keep, You know, like Sinners, for example, he actually got a witch's earring out of a freaking accessory add-on shop, and I want to slap him for that because I'm like, what the hell? He's the one of the luckiest guys I've ever been seeing lately, and he gets a freaking witch's earring, and I'm like, okay, cool. It's like, and I'm like, yeah, and he's like, oh, I think I'm gonna sell it. I'm like, don't sell that. You keep it. That means you just need like. Four more, and he's set. He's a ranger. I think he's around my CP. He might be a little. He might. I think he's higher than me though, by 100 points, I believe. So, still level 9. This thing's killing me. Let's go. So I'm just trying to get through boss rushes right now. So I'm trying to power level my horse with boss rushes. Because for some reason, getting that level 9 to level 10 is the biggest pain in the butt when you're leveling your horses up. For some reason, that level feels like it's like 5, 7 levels in one. It's really messed up. 3.4. Oh, he's at 3,400? Yeah, I'm still catching up. I haven't seen your gear recently, what it is and stuff like that. You've probably been playing last 2 days like a maniac. Yeah, you're just using your purple plus 5 gear you have, right? Yeah. I'm slowly trying to get all my yellows into plus 5. It's gonna be a long process, but I believe in myself. No, I'm going for a yellow. I want to have a plus 5 yellows. So, okay, Sinners, you know what I did yesterday? I managed... Remember, I had like about 600 boss stamps and stuff like that. I managed to get through all those boss rushes 2 days ago, or actually I finished up yesterday. I had over 5,000 ancient gold coins. I didn't even get one yellow, not even one yellow out of the shop. I was so sad. I was like, really? It took me hours. Not even one yellow. And that's the second time I got to 5,000 gold ancient coins. It's that second time I didn't get anything. But when I try to do it with like less than 500 ancient coins, I'll get 2 yellows. Heck, I got in my orange when I only had 150 coins. I was just like, oh, just open up this, you know, just this chest piece just once. And boom, orange. I'm like... I feel like there's like almost like the RNG is against you when you're trying to when you have too many gold coins. I almost feel like the RNG is just against you at this point. It's like, I feel like it's rigged that way. But then again, it could be just RNG. See here. Oh yeah, I don't know if I told you this, Sinners, but I did a crazy thing. I don't know if you're gonna notice. Oh yeah, I've seen that. Recently, what was it? The Ranger who was level 54, she got a Kazarka longbow. Yeah. So do you notice my Witch's Noelle outfit? It's actually 17 attack, 17 AP and 17 DP. I combined my seasonal outfit with the Noelle outfit because I got tired of looking at that outfit. I didn't like it. For some reason, I got bored looking at it. It's not a very good looking outfit. I just wanted the AP and DP. And I think this outfit is much cuter on my character, with especially with the nose. I got the nose and everything. I'm set. But it sucks that you have to waste a costume, and you cannot just switch between costumes. No, I pretty much wasted over $100 to get my seasonal weapon and armor. Over $100. I don't advise that for anybody. Unless you have money to burn, don't do it. That 10 AP DP is definitely that is so not worth it. Unless the seasonal offer is really cool looking, like the Ranger one. The Ranger offer is really awesome looking. The Berserker and the Berserker outfits are pretty cool looking. The Knight's outfits are like, pretty cool looking. Those are cool looking outfits. Witch's outfit? I hate it. I honestly hate it. I wish it was something completely different. I really do. It's just really weird and really quirky. Yeah, I think I got my weapon on like a fourth try. But I do feel bad for one guy who wasted it. What was it? He used up, it was a whale. What was it? $5,000 to get a perfect 25-25 CP seasonal item. In my mind, that's like, whoa, bro. It's like you got money to burn. Like you got money to burn. Like whatever you're doing, if you can burn that much money on a video game, bro, keep doing it. And I love whales. Don't get me wrong. I love whales. I love whales because they allow they give a support that games need. Oh, I'm really slowed down. I'm gonna die here again. I don't want to die. Side over here. Dodge, dodge, you fool. Why aren't you dodging? This character doesn't want to dodge. I'm gonna try blue chips very soon, either tonight or something like that, because yeah, when you're getting stuck in the Immolator to try to dodge and your character's just like, nah, I'm not gonna go over here. I'm gonna go over right there. There we go. Dude, here's my biggest regret. As a mobile, when I played one of the phone games, it was a Summoner's War. I regret ever finding out about that game. I have wasted over $1,000 on Summoner's War over the course of like a year that I've been playing. I was playing that game, and at that point, I'm like, "Yeah, it feels bad, man. It feels really bad." This horse doesn't want experience, I swear. Yeah, I don't understand. Like I don't understand. Like I completely understand how you can spend so much money on a mobile game because they make it so easy, and they make it so you want it to do it. So that's why I love Black Desert Mobile. They're not forcing it onto you. They're not pushing it into your face. They're not giving you all these billion advertisements like, hey, you gotta buy this, you gotta buy this, you gotta buy this. when you spend money on Black Desert, you actually want to spend it on your own. Like, it's you going to them, not them for shoving it down your throat. You know? That I'll give one props for Pearl Abyss for doing that. At least they're being nice about that side, you know? Because they totally could have done that. They totally could have, like, do all those crazy advertisements. They totally could have done all these weird stuff. And it feels very claustrophobic when somebody does that. Like, when I see it, when the moment I start seeing that in any kind of phone game, like, I quit. I uninstall it instantly. I basically look at it, I'm like, uninstall. The moment I see a cash shop or anything like that being advertised like that throughout the game, I quit. I instantly quit. And if the only progress to go forward is to actually spend money, yeah, no. Like, this game, I looked at Korean version of this game. This game has a future. This is going to be the better version of Black Desert. It plays pretty well. It's a lot of fun. And it doesn't have a lot of annoying things that Black Desert has, and I enjoy that. Correct, and I'm in the same boat, Fox. If you give me enough entertainment to basically meet the value of how much I'm putting into the game, and you give me just as much of entertainment, I am willing to spend the money. If there's ever comes out an MMORPG where the monthly cost is $100 a month, I will pay for it, but it has to meet that $100 a month quality. You know? Because as long as you can meet that quality, I am willing to give you the price. Like, if they ever made literally Sword Art Online, and I'm talking about not the cutesy anime version, but actually MMORPG, where you can fully go in, feel, smell, you know, full body virtual reality MMORPG, I'm willing to pay you. I'll pay $250 a month right now. I'm willing to give you $250 a month right now. Because I find that MMORPGs are one of those few category of video games that will give you an experience like unlike any other. You meet wonderful people, you meet terrible people, you'll meet people you want to hate, you'll meet people you want to compete against, you'll meet rivals, you'll cry, you'll laugh, you have some. MMORPGs are one of those few genres that will give you an emotion of a full experience. And sometimes you can make friends for life. So, yeah, that's, I definitely would say, I'm willing. If somebody or some company out there, Amazon, Google, or somebody out there is willing to go that extra mile, you know, to release a game like that, I'll be one of the first people. Like, if somebody's willing to put up like $1 to $5 billion that it takes to make that game, I'm willing to be one of the first people to put down $100 a month, every month, as long as they'll provide gameplay that I'm looking for. Honestly, I feel like World of Warcraft became sort of like their financial system of Blizzard revolves too much around World of Warcraft. And instead of being that extra money, they use all that money from World of Warcraft to fund all of their other projects or to keep the company going. That's what I feel like about World of Warcraft. That'd be kind of interesting, MMORPG. If Blizzard didn't have World of Warcraft right now, I feel like they would have closed a long time ago. especially when they lost a lot of their talent during like late 2000s and stuff like that. They would have closed a long time ago if there was no World of Warcraft. That amount of money that video game made alone for that company, it basically allowed them to keep their doors open. And they still had to do, like, what was it, last year? They had to cut a lot of employees. Diablo and StarCraft are the two games I grew up on. As a 11, 12, 13-year-old kid playing Diablo 1 through 2 during those times, it was one of my best experiences ever in, like, my middle school, grade school, and high school. I loved Diablo lore. I loved Warcraft 2 and Warcraft 3. They're great games. I'm looking forward to the remake that's coming out in January. I already pre-purchased it like a month ago. So I'm looking forward to that remake. Well, I wouldn't say they're greedy. I would say it's not the same company anymore. The employees who are there, a lot of them are not the same employees anymore. The people who first created that company, most of them are not there anymore. And basically what Activision came in, what they end up doing over the years, they slowly would take out people who made Blizzard special, and they would put in their own person in there. You know, you can see that across multiple companies. How many times do you have a manager or somebody who leads a group doesn't have a clue about video games? I bet you there's a lot of managers that know how to lead people, but they have no idea about the product they're selling, because all they know how to do is manage people. You know, and like, you know, they would just want to keep their job, and all they care about is a payment. Most of them are not going to be passionate about, you know, getting that best video game or getting that best quality out there. This game right here, this is what Black Desert Mobile is doing right now. It's showing the world that a video game on a phone can be a really good video game. If this is the future that we're slowly going towards on, like, you know, games similar quality as this game right here, I say bring in more mobile games. But the problem is that once people are going to see how successful this game is going to become, there's going to be a lot of companies they're going to try to copy. And then market is going to get saturated. And then we're going to have a lot of shitty versions of Black Desert. And companies who are not as committed to quality. The same thing happened with World of Warcraft. When World of Warcraft first came out and they showed how much money they're making every month, everybody wanted to get in on it. There were so many MMORPGs made. And then look at it like the timeline right now. There's hardly any of those MMORPGs around anymore. A lot of them are dead, don't have a population. They're very niche community. They're not updated anymore. Closed down, shut down. Or they're bad to be from the start. I don't even know what Battle Royale Fever is. See? The few games that I played decently on a phone game. Okay, let me see. So I was an EverQuest person. I'm from Ashland's Call. And to this day, if you ever ask me what is the best MMORPG I ever played, I'll tell you it was Ashland's Call. That game, to this day, I have yet to see the features, the awesomeness, and the coolness, some of the stuff they did in that game. I'm yet to see it in any other game, in any other MMORPG. I don't know if EQ set it up. I'm pretty sure they came out around the same time. EverQuest and Ashland's Call. Like, Ashland's Call. It's that MMORPG is not around anymore. And what made that game special, especially on the PvP server, was a bug. What made that game special was a bug. The bugs in that game actually made the game really special. Yeah, Astron Skull, you got it. That is the best MMORPG I ever played in my life. It's not around anymore. The servers have been closed down by Tribune, when Tribune used to be great. They had very unique combat. They had a fully open world. There was no hand-holding. You basically followed rumors, you explored, and then you found like portals and dungeons, which were all public. That means you could have anybody walking into any dungeon. There was no instances whatsoever. So if somebody wanted to murder you, you know, or fight you, they could follow you into those dungeons. It was a really awesome game. Now, the best part about it was you actually had a really strong community when it came to guilds in that game. Yeah, so you had a lot of cool stuff. You had like death items, which were basically you would farm for these specific high-valued items so that you would drop those items instead of your equipment. So you would go out farming, and even trash items would be useful if they were high value, because you would keep it on your character, and then you would drop that if you got killed or murdered by somebody, and you wouldn't lose your gear and stuff like that. The new max level is 60, Watto. So the new max level is 60. But your Black Spirit level doesn't have a cap. You can keep leveling. If you keep sacrificing items to Black Spirit, you can keep leveling above the level cap. So you can still be getting a little bit more powerful if you put more time or effort into this game. So I am looking forward to Pearl's Abyss, Crimson Desert. I am looking forward to whenever they decide to release that game, I am looking forward to how it's going to look. Yeah, don't worry about rushing, Watto. Take your time. This game is not about rushing. Like you gotta take everything step by step and take patience and take your time. Cause if you rush, you're gonna make mistakes. You're gonna put too much money into the game. You're gonna use pearls incorrectly. You're gonna make bad decisions. Just take your time. Enjoy the game for what it is. A nice, fun, grindy game on mobile phones that is a really good quality, very nice graphics. I've been gathering a lot of knowledges as I can. Right now I've just been focusing on like progressing a little bit in the main quest, and I'm trying to get my CP as high as I can so I can farm in certain areas without a problem. Also, I'm trying to get ahead of curve right now, because right now all the people are trying to catch up and get into the 3000 and stuff like that. And what I'm trying to accomplish right now is basically find out where are some good farming spots and, you know, good places to get your stuff. That's what I did too, Fox. And you haven't spent any pearls? My friend, you are a stronger man than I am. It's like I already spent like about 400, 500 bucks on this game. And I have no regrets. I don't regret one thing about spending the money. I like it. I love it. It keeps me entertained. So far, I played it nonstop since it released, which is, 3 weeks ago? I can't say the same thing about a lot of games out there. So in my mind, it's giving me the entertainment that I need. And it gives me entertainment for hours. And it's plus, the cool thing about this game as well, the game works around my lifestyle. What I mean by that is that I don't have to be in front of my phone and play this game to get a little bit ahead in the game. You know, the Black Spirit is awesome. The auto combat is awesome. I can basically turn on Black Spirit before I go to work, turn it off when I come back out of work. And it gives you that satisfaction of having something to look forward to. So basically, I don't mind the collection tab, mostly because it's stuff that's like it's like blue and green stuff. Blue and green stuff means nothing to me. Blue and green stuff, I sacrifice anything that's under yellow. I sacrifice to the Black Spirit. I don't sell any of that. Unless it's a jewelry, I sacrifice everything else to Black Spirit. So let me even like show you. Still not level 10. This is some messed up horse, I tell you. No. So I don't sacrifice jewelry. Jewelry, I do not sacrifice. I don't sacrifice jewelry. Jewelry, I actually sell in the market. Yeah, I sell jewelry. Any jewelry I get, I actually sell on the market. Armor pieces and stuff like that, I sell. I keep clicking the wrong one. So, currently I'm level 119. But jewelry, I don't sacrifice any. Sometimes I get rid of white jewelry if it fills up my inventory a little bit too much. But jewelry, I don't sell. I sell it on a black market. So if you look at my market even, I can show you. See, I sell all my greens, my purples, my gold. This is all the stuff I have on my market right now. Sure, what's your question? I have a policy of not selling gold items because they're so rare. I prefer to sell it and hopefully another player is able to buy it, because I rather populate the market with the yellows for other people than actually to sacrifice to Black Spirit. Because I don't like I think it's wasteful to sacrifice yellow items to Black Spirit just to increase my advantage. I think it's just waste. I'd rather give it a chance for somebody else to buy it, you know? Like, you know, a player who's just starting out and he needs a cheap yellow weapon. If you notice, like, my weapons, I even sell a lot of my stuff for under the price. I don't do the maximum price on everything unless it's something, like, really hard to get. So, like, even, like, look at my weapon right here. This weapon, I just got this weapon overnight, this yellow weapon. I actually got it this morning when I started my Black Spirit. So I got this weapon off of Black Spirit. It's actually at the lowest price right now on the market. I can't even lower it because that's the lowest price on the market. So that's why I will not sacrifice. That's why I won't sacrifice, you know, stuff like that. I mean, like, let me even look at the... How much is Liverto staff even? My Liverto staff. Did it go down? Okay, so somebody just beat me. So the price has gone down on a Liverto staff. So now it's under 9 mil. It wasn't 9 mil yesterday when I put it up. But it's still only 9,600. So it's still not maximum price. You can adjust the price. So when you do a plus and you add an item. So let me do it on the ring. E-ring. You have a mini price and you have a max price. You can actually click on these tabs and the price that you register it at will change. You can also click on the actual price by per tab and you can actually change it to what you want it to. Jewelry, on the other hand, I will put a maximum price on because they're black pearls, basically. Sounds good. My wife wants to go on a walk soon, so I'm probably gonna disappear very soon here, like in the next half an hour or something like that, to 45 minutes, and we're gonna go on a walk. I love you guys, but I gotta keep my marriage alive, you know. Happy wife, happy life. So let's see. Yeah, thanks. Happy Xmas, Mr. Foxbite. More like Happy New Year. So I'm looking forward to 2020. Yeah, no problem. If you ever want to see me, you know, know when I get on, just send a follow or anything like that. That's always appreciated. Otherwise, if not, just try to keep an eye on me on Black Desert Mobile. I'm always happy here to talk and explain or answer any questions. The better jewelry. I believe plus 5 enhance is better. A purple plus jewelry plus 5 enhance is better. Oh, thanks so much, Fox. And thanks again for following me. Really appreciate it. I believe a purple jewelry that's plus 5 is better, but it really comes down to your luck. If you manage to get a couple good drops and stuff like that, yellow or orange might be your better choice, but it really comes down to you. Because I believe a plus 5 jewelry is equal to an orange. Good luck with everything, Fox. So let's take a look at an example here. Yeah, I would say if you don't looking to spend a lot of money, yeah, I'll be on tomorrow. I usually stream after I get off work. So on average I stream sometime usually after 4 or 5 Central Time, and I usually stay up streaming up to like midnight on average, sometimes even past midnight. It really comes down to the day. All comes down to if I have anything going on, but most of the time I stream between those times, between 4 p.m. Central and midnight Central. But it was nice meeting you. Yeah, I'm NA. I'm in United States. I have an accent. I'm from Europe. I'm Polish. So so I know all about Europe. Nice. This guy's kicking my butt. Yeah, I would, Wado, I would definitely level up your purples. So I chose my own build, and that's just based on my own style and testing. What I do usually is I let the game, because I'm playing on an emulator. Yeah, no problem. It's because I play on an emulator, and this emulator is not very good when it comes to like switching the tab and clicking all different skills and stuff like that. It's not as smooth. That's why I'm thinking of trying out the blue chip emulator. A lot of people, I heard that it's not as pretty, but it plays better. The problem is that like it gets weirdly stuck. Moomoo player? I'll try that one out too. Because yeah, it's driving me, because sometimes I want to dodge, I want to move, and like it doesn't register correctly, so I'm stuck there and I'm getting a full hit from a boss. Yeah, right now I'm playing on a Nox, but I'm definitely I'll try that MIMO player first before I try BlueStacks then. That's good. That see that's good to hear that it's like that it's like so smooth. I'll definitely try it out because like yeah, I've been looking into this because sometimes I just want to move and I want to dodge and my character doesn't want to walk at all. It's just like I'm gonna move backwards and I'm like, okay, well I guess we're dying right now. See, like right there. I wanted to dodge off to the side. Instead, it wants to go backwards and dodge backwards. And I'm like, really? Okay, cool. It's like. Anybody else find it disturbing that my healing is 666? I don't know if anybody noticed that even yet. At level 23, healing. Your healing is 666, which is really funny that they actually allowed that. Because if this was a American MMORPG, it would have been like 667 or something different. Ouch. That hurt. Uh-oh. He spins to win. Okay. Is my horse level 10 yet? Come on. This horse, it has a mind of its own, I swear. Or is it just bugged? At this point, I think it's my horse is bugged. He says it's at 86%. Okay. We're getting there. And apparently it has a fast learner perk, but I'm not sure if that affects experience or anything like that. So the pets are really useful. Right now in the air, certain areas that I'm farming at. So basically every time you get a higher level tier pet as you go up, it lowers the cooldown on how often they will auto loot. At a higher levels, and I noticed that in a couple areas in the 3200 areas, is that if I try to loot anything, I end up either murdered or literally an inch of my life. So pets are the only way I can pick up loot in some of those areas because I'm surrounded by like 10, 20 mobs, and I have no chance whatsoever to actually or time to pick up loot because the moment I stop casting and the moment I stop seeing them, it's the moment I end up dying. And this happened numerous times, like last night. Like I died so many times every time I try to pick up loot, because they spawn so fast and they gank you so fast that waiting for the auto path to walk up to the loot and then picking it up, your health is gonna drop below half. And it's crazy that I'm reaching that point now with the pets. So pets are definitely gonna be worth it. But I would say you should get your pets to tier two. You should get to tier two. The one of the easiest ways you can get a lot of pets right now is like $20. So yeah, you want to have three pets, and I would say go for a tier two pets. It will make your life a lot easier. Also, it helps you a lot during oops. It helps you out a lot during what's it called? When you do Black Spirit, when you have Black Spirit farming for you while you're AFK and stuff like that, it will help you a lot more. Main reason why is because maybe because right is because you're gonna get more gear, you're gonna get more loot. I noticed that if I don't have my three pets fed, and you're not gonna get as much loot. Or if I only have one pet working or two pets, you're still gonna get a lot less loot picked up than if you have all three when you do the AFK mode. So you gotta make sure, and the higher tier or the higher ranking you have, I feel like from my experience at least, it affects it as well with how much, because I believe they take into calculation into their random loot that it drops. It takes they take it into calculation. Oh, I got a quick phone call. I hope everybody else that's watching the stream is having a good day. And even if you don't talk, it's okay. Just want to wish you guys all Happy New Year. Yes, finally, level 10. Woo! It freaking finally did it. About damn time. That took forever. Come on. What? I didn't ask for this. Out. Let's go to the camp. Cubia has appeared. Interesting. I'm gonna wait for Watto to get back before I do this, just so he doesn't miss on it or anything like that. Voltaics got it conquered 35. Came a bit on it. Yeah, somebody did sell that one longbow. And I guess that's what Bumble bought. Staffs. We get nothing. Boom, 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 boom. I don't know if that's even worth getting just for 10 AP. It's probably more once you upgrade it, but still. This is definitely what I want. 29. Such a lovely staff. But no luck. Just nope. Oh, where is it? There it is. Huh, there's definitely a lot more streamers for Black Desert than they were just a couple days ago, or when it first started out. That's interesting. But I don't know any of these streamers. Oh hey, how are you going? How's it going, Zao? I would try to pronounce your name, but I feel like I'm gonna butcher it. Zaldiak. Yep, I just tried just there. I butchered it. Oh sweet, you're a new witch. Nice. How you like it? Okay, cool. Do you have any questions or any information you might need? Yeah. Just go at it, man. Just gonna go nuts. Like, I love sharing information and stuff like that. I'm always happy to. So weird as it is, they're both right. And here's why. It comes down to how lucky you're gonna get, what's gonna drop for you, what's available.
Powering off. Powering on. Mic on.
Test.
Test.
Test. There we go. I think I'm back. I'm alive. I don't know what I did. It just worked. I'm just gonna go with it. Voodoo magic. Okay. Sorry. And Quest, welcome to the stream. What I was saying, Zowel, it comes down to your luck and what's available to you. And what I mean by that is basically a good accessories to focus on. Focus on the ones that give you critical hit chance and the one that give you attack. If you focus on attack speed and critical hit chance, blue jewelry and getting it to +5, it's worth doing it. The main reason why I say that is because you get these little bonuses. Let me combine my horse really quickly. And I can show you what I mean by that. Oh, I got braiding still on one of them. It's actually good to. Let's see here. Okay, if I exit here. It means it basically it's a title you get for when you played it before global release. Apparently, I started on playing on global release, but apparently, I still got the title. So it's kind of funny that it worked out that way. I have no idea how. But it still gave me, even though I didn't play softcore release, I think it gave it to me. Maybe because I pre-ordered the game and stuff like that, or pre-registered. So, right above your health, there's a little jewelry, like a little ring icon. You get these renaissances, right? And getting your jewelry, like a blue jewelry, to +5, it's useful. I got a full set of +10 jewelry on my alt that I created as a way of just testing stuff out. And I definitely do a lot of damage. I do a lot of other, like, and it's a really good jewelry to have up to, like, till you get a yellow. And it only costed me maybe, I don't know, about 500, no, it cost me about, I think, 1,000 black pearls to get all my jewelry to +10, my green jewelry. But there are differences. So, the purple and yellow jewelry have extra stat that you cannot get much of on the blue and green jewelry, and that's what you're missing out on. In the long term, purple and yellow jewelry are always going to be a lot more better, even if you just get the basic version of them. And here's why. if you're lucky and if you're able to get this Nereti set items, like the earrings, the, you know, the necklace, the ring, the belt, you know, anything that's Nereti, it's good to get because it gives you 300 HP. And that stat alone is worth going for purple or jewelry, for yellow jewelry. So, if you ask me, you know, pre 3000 CP, I would say blue jewelry plus 5, sure. Anything after 3000 CP, you want to have a yellow jewelry. And mostly reason why is it's for that HP buff, so you can survive getting hit in the face. Because the bosses after 3000 CP are going to hit you in the face hard. And on top of it, and I'll show you this in this area, because this is a great area to show you an example. In Omar Lava Cave, this is one of the new areas that just came out. Just do your dailies. Just do your dailies and check your accessory. Under Cash Up, check your accessory where you get your free accessories. Where you check your free accessories and stuff like that. So, you start to get into these kind of areas. And when you start to get into these kind of areas, these guys hit hard. And I'm talking about these guys hit hard. Like really, really hard. And the only thing that's keeping me alive and me be able to farm in this area is my HP jewelry. Is what, and keeping everything CC down. If I try to, like, and I'm waiting for something to drop, like, hopefully something will drop soon. HP becomes a more important stat on your rank and your jewelry at a higher level, because it's what will keep you alive at these higher levels. Oh man, is there nothing that's gonna drop? Oh, these guys are hungry. A nice way to get a lot of black stones is basically killing the event trees. So if you click on your global map, you're going to see a golden icons next to certain names of areas. That is because you have special creatures spawning in there. These little guys. You see these big tall trees? You want to kill these little suckers. Because they have the same drop loot system as violent monsters. And they're much easier to kill. And they drop black stones like crazy. And they drop the purple ones. They drop the purple weapon and armor black stones. Let me even show you, for example, let me see if I can find any. So killing these special symbol violent version of monsters and killing the event items that we have, event trees that we have right now, the Christmas trees, is going to be the best way for you to get your black stones currently. You'll get it faster than any other way. Also, you want to do your boss rushes and other things like that. So, not the tiny ones. You want to kill the golden, not the tiny ones. You want to kill the golden symbol ones. Let me see if I can find one real quickly for you. They spawn pretty frequently in most of the areas that they spawn them in. But let me see if I can find one real quickly here. So you see this tall tree right here? These tall little bastards. Look how easy it is to kill them. Literally two abilities, two shots. I just killed that one in two shots. Right? But if I try to kill a violent one. Welcome back. It's going to take a lot longer for me to kill these guys. And they have the exact same loot system. They'll drop the same exact items. And they hit harder. Okay, so you have these white little symbols. And I just got a purple blackstone. So let me go to the map while my character kills. You want to go to the areas that have these gold symbols next to them. So notice, like, next to the name, there's gold symbols. That's where they spawn. They only spawn on those maps that have those gold symbols next to the name. And if you just focus on killing those gold symbol trees and just focus on killing every single violent creature, you'll get probably on average anywhere between 50 to 200 blackstones an hour. Like, if you find a good place. Hidden monasteries are a really good place at early levels, like between levels 45, or more precisely around 2400 CP and 3000 CP. Hidden monasteries are a pretty good place for them. There's a lot of violent creatures in there, and there's a lot of trees that spawn in there. It's actually located in... My map thing is bugging out. It's located in Calpheon. It's in the same area as the Southwest Calpheon. The Hidden Monastery. It's right here in the middle of the map. You kill by basically a bunch of Shadow Knights. And there's a lot of trees there. There's a lot of golden trees that spawn there. And there's a lot of Shadow Knight violence that spawn there. You can literally run around in a circle on that map. And pretty much you're going to get about anywhere between one to five every like 2 to 3 minutes. And the drop rates are pretty good. And most of the time you get a Blackstone. Thanks for the follow, Zao. Appreciate it. It's a pretty good spot. The Hidden Monastery is a pretty good spot if you want to get a lot of Blackstones from the event creatures and from the violent creatures. Also, you have a chance of gaining a Mark of the Shadow, and if that drops, you're pretty much set. You can get yourself pretty much with that alone. You can probably get yourself a couple good yellow jewelry pieces, or you can get yourself a full set, probably of +5 purple jewelry set. My friend Sinner, he has a full +5 purple set. He loves that. He went straight for the purple set, and he has no regrets whatsoever. Like, I would skip the blue. Blue is kind of in a weird place. I would say either go with a green +10 or go with a purple +5. Or, in my case, what I did is I end up getting a little bit lucky. I had a couple belts drop. I bought all my rings. So I bought 4 rings of Red Curl. And Narati necklace and Narati earrings, it just dropped in the cash shop. You just got to be patient with it. I still haven't found anything to replace my Morik bracelet. But I've been basically buying this bracelet from the market because they were pretty cheap. Nobody wanted to buy these ones just because there was HP and movement speed. But I'll take HP over anything else. Market shop, sorry. Market shop. And the other shop that you want to under add-ons, the accessory shop. But here's to show you an example why I love HP over anything else. So let me try to loot. I'm gonna loot this item right there. So I'm gonna go loot this item right there. So it auto pass, it picks it up, and I picked up. But look, I'm already half health just by picking up one item, and I would have taken more damage if that guy wasn't there. In Shock Chat, you basically change your gold coins into gear. I basically anything that's below yellow, I sacrifice to Black Spirit automatically, unless I need it for my collection. So I got a couple gold coins right now, right? So the way I do it. And this is random for everybody. What do you mean by colored names? Are you talking about like ones that are like really orange or red or white or green? I would say stick to anything that's like white and green. Like stick to areas that are like white and green. The main reason why I say that is because if you try to fight stuff that's orange and above, it's gonna be inefficient. You're gonna be wasting a lot of money on potions. You're gonna be wasting a lot of you're not gonna be killing as fast. You're not gonna get as much loot or farm up as much money or as much items. When you do Black Spirit, it's a little different story. You always want to go to the maximum area that you can handle that's not orange. As long as you go in an area that's not orange, and I'm talking about like white or green, you're gonna get a good amount of gear from those areas. If you try to Black Spirit, which is AFK, you know, hunting when you're not looking at your game, you're not gonna get hardly any gear. You're just gonna waste your time. And on top of it, the Black Spirit is just gonna eat up all your potions. So that's one thing you wanna remember. You want to go get in an area or farm an area where you don't use up your potions like nonstop. Like if you're rebuying potions every hour or every 2 hours when you're grinding in that area, that's probably not the area you should be grinding in. Also, grind in the areas if you're trying to get a specific item. And what I mean by that is that when you look at the world maps... My character's not like stuck weirdly. Like you always like, for example, like once you get to, you know, once you get around 2700, like once you get to around 2700, 2800, you want to come to abandoned iron mine. Why? Because you have a chance of getting orange main hand weapons drop here. You have a chance of dropping your main hand gold weapons. So if you don't have either of those, this is where you want to come to and you want to farm. This is where you want to AFK farm right now. You want to farm at this area. Because getting your, like, you know, your Liverto stuff. Like, if you want to buy a yellow weapon, always buy Liverto. Don't buy any other yellow weapon. If you're going to buy something for out of the market, buy a Liverto. Liverto is the weapon to get every single time. Why? Because it's the highest AP damage it does. And on top of it, it gives you 2 gem slots. And gems are very important. You want to put basically the strength gems. And then the other gems you can put into it is, in my case, I do swiftness gems. And you want those gems second ability. So for example, when strength gems as a witch, I focus on Ahibi and I focus on Al damage. Those are my 2 categories I selected for myself to use as my sap category. That means everything I get is always Ahibi or Al damage add-on. And what I mean by that, and this is something a lot of pros don't tell anybody or a lot of people don't know about, is you choose 2 categories of damage. You choose 2 branches of damage. You choose L damage and Ahibi damage, and those are the 2 best branches for a witch. So I'm putting it from my, it might be different for each class, but 2 best branches for a witch are L and Ahibi damage. And those are the two you should focus on, because you're gonna do most damage. And notice how much percentage I have of my Al and Ahibi damage. They're almost each of them are almost 30%. That's a lot of extra damage. But here's the way I do it though. Every single gem I have that's inserted into these is one of those two categories. I don't have any Serent. I think the only thing I have of Serent is. I think it's a light forge stone. But everything else is Ahibi or Al damage for all my items, because all that damage just stacks up. And when I hit with those abilities, they hit hard, and I can kill stuff above my even above my CP by like 200, 300 difference in CP. I can actually do damage to those mobs because of that, because of the branch damage. So that's something some people don't focus on, and that's a big no-no. You should focus on that. You shouldn't go into all four, because all four make no it makes no difference for you. You only want to focus on two branches of damage, and it's different based on your classes. Like in my case, you know, you have Labrivi and you have your Al. I always will choose Al over Labrivi. Now, the other one is, I'm trying to find it. The other ones would be Serret. Now the problem is with Serret, like yeah, it looks like it's very useful, like increases the number of enemies affected by your skill. But honestly, I kill faster, like I kill them all faster than they can spawn, and my skill cooldown goes down really quickly. I do not pick skill damage over crit. So first thing you focus on as much as you can, you focus on getting your crit and your attack speed as high as possible. Those are the two things you want to focus on. Getting your crit chance and your attack speed. Crit chance should be your number one thing you max out, and it should be very easy. Most stuff out there will give you crit. Like Grineel Helmet gives you 4% crit. Like you can get Grineel gloves give you 4% attack speed. A lot of jewelry will give you critical chance. Like basically, like my belt has critical chance, my necklace has critical chance, my earring has critical chance. But the main reason why I focus so much on critical chance on those is so that way I don't have to focus on putting in critical chance gems, and I put instead attack gems in there, or I put attack speed gems to get closer to the max cap. I ran out of as you can see right here, this is not the area I would come in and farm. The only time when I come into this area was to do a main quest and to do grinding for the violent and trees right now, currently. That is the only reason I ever come here anymore to in this area, because this is not an area I should be in to farm for stuff. Because as you can see, I went through 500 pots just like a snap of fingers. That is not a place you want to farm in. When you're going through, you know, a stack of 500 potions like a snap of fingers, that is a lot of wasted money. A lot of wasted money. That's 250k a pop every like half an hour to an hour. You don't want to farm in an area like that. If you can farm in an area that has either golden weapons or a specific piece of gear that might drop. So like let's say you have purple gloves, and you really want yellow gloves, farm overnight in an area that basically drops yellow gloves for you. And you should always prioritize armor over a weapon. Main reason why? You can move the armor across all your characters, and whatever progress you do in armor, be enchanting, be putting crystals in, be getting your, you know, getting it to +30, getting it to +35. Focus on armor more than you would focus on a weapon. Main reason why I say that? Because the armor will go across all your characters. You can move that armor to any character, and you'll be able to use it. You move it over to an alt you wanna basically grind with, so you can get more materials and more enchanting stones and stuff like that. Do it. Running alts is a really, really profitable way of making a lot of money. You guys want to have the best way, you know, if you want to put as little money into this game as you can, make alts, run them through the main quest, run them from a level one, at least up to the Crone Castle. Every time you do that, you're going to get about 60 mil of worth of materials, and just keep doing that. Sure, it'll take you maybe 6 to 8 hours, you know. It'll get faster as your gear level increases, as your CP increases, because you're going to be able to kill a lot more faster. And eventually, you're going to get to the point that you're going to be able to go from, like, level 1 to level 55, you know, up to Crone Castle within just a couple hours. Like, you'll be done before you know it. And that also gives you contribution points, so you can hire more workers. That will give you all the blackstones you need to upgrade your gear. That will give you all the extra materials like crystals that you can combine and fuse to make better crystals. So yeah, that's the best way for somebody who doesn't want to put a lot of real money into this game. Run alts from main quest to the last quest. And here's a better tip. Don't run different classes. Run exactly the same class that your main character is. And here's the reason why. Because you're going to get skill books. Instead of using all those skill books on your alt, save them. Give them to your main character. While you're farming your... Not only are you going to be getting your skill books for your main character, but you're also going to be getting so much money and so much material that... You're going to be able to either sell it all on the market, B, use it for your main character, and you're going to skyrocket with CP. You know? And get yourself decent pets. Like, I would say, if you're starting out, get yourself 3 tier 2 sea pets. It won't cost you that much. You're probably looking at about, depends on your luck, maybe around $20 to $40. You're looking at about $20 to $40. Or, you know, if you farm up enough silver, buy it off the auction house. If you're on a Madea, you're probably gonna see a lot of pets on the auction house. Unfortunately, I'm on Heidel. I don't get that much lucky. Like, you get one pet every maybe an hour or two. You don't get that many pets. At least not in my area. So. But yeah, if you want to make a lot of money, a lot of materials, and progress your character a lot, create an alt that is exact same alt as your character, and then just storage all the skill books that drop for you while you're running that character through. You do that once or twice, you'll hit 20. Crone Castle. That is if you don't want to get too crazy with CP. Like, that is until you can get past 3,000 CP. Crone Castle. So to show you, it's gonna be in Balanos. There's the Crone Castle. Once you get through side quest of this Crone Castle, that's where you wanna run it to. Up to this Crone Castle right here. Right next to Velia in Balanos area. Well, Squazio, here's what I did. Because I'm in the same shoes as you. I would do one of two things. And this is based on your preference. I would go either A... And this is what I'm doing, like what I did. I start focusing on the main armor pieces that you do want to drop as an orange or a red. So imagine which armor pieces red that are quality orange or red you wanted to have. Because that also will get you a lot of money. I would focus either on a chest or I would focus on a main weapon. And if you get... Because you can get Kazarka out of this. So you gotta always remember, red gear can drop out of Shataku's gear shop. So I would personally go for armor. I would go either for a chest piece or I would go for a main hand. I already got a chess piece. So, hi, Bim Spread. It means basically what quality gear you have a higher chance of dropping, Watto. That's basically shows you gear level, quality of gear level, that you have an easier time of finding. And thanks for the follow, Squazio. And thanks for the follow, Watto. We appreciate it, guys. And hi, Bim Spread. Hopefully I'm saying that right. So let's give it a shot. If I get a red, guys, I'm quitting right now. I'm ending the stream because that's the best way to end. So if I get a red right now, I want to say it's all thanks to you. You're all rubbing off luck on me. Oh, thank you. Oh, hey, we got yellow. We got one yellow. Let's see if we can get a luckier. Come on, orange. I need that orange staff. I need that orange staff. Come on. Stream luck. I need that real stream luck. I need that orange stream luck. I don't think it's gonna happen, but I can wait. What was that? Oh, that's. I thought it was like something happened just for a second. Nope. I don't think it's gonna happen, guys. Ah! I'm gonna stop right there. I'm gonna try for gloves, just out of curiosity. I just want to see what happens. We got a purple. That got sacrificed. And got anything? And another purple, and that got sacrificed. So yeah, one gold. Woo! Hey, how's it going, Kata? Oh, awesome! Thanks for the follow as well. I'm getting a lot of follows today. And now to sell on the market. And I don't even know where the market is at this moment. My brain just like went frozen. Sell. We're gonna sell it for 2.4, the lowest price possible, so somebody out there can get themselves a yellow staff a little bit cheaper. And next we go. Oh yeah, what orange did you get though, Brim Sprat? Well, Catastrophe, did you, dude, come on, Ms. Fram. That is the only orange you need. You don't need any other orange. Every other orange you should be farming for. Because I think you just run out of luck on that. Like, once you get that, I don't think you're going to get any other orange. The game just kind of went like, well, we're going to give you all the luck in this one draw. And that's it. Dude, that's like the best staff you can get. Like, next to Kazarka. You're set. Your character is set for weapons. you're a lucky guy. Oh, I forgot. We have one more thing I can do. I can open up all this bustle loot. Let's see if we get anything. If we get a red, I'm going to laugh so hard. Nope, we're not going to get a red. Like, nothing? Anything? Nothing? Anything? Nope, nothing. You got more gloves? Okay, Catastrophe, back to your question. Sorry, I'm like going all over the place trying to read everybody's chat. I would get your tier 2 pets if you don't have that yet. If you have the pearls to do so, I would try to get yourself a tier 2 pets. Another one to get useful to use, at least one, or at least to do at least once, is I would get myself... let me see if I can find it. I would go under add-ons and I would buy myself at least one relic. I would purchase this, at least one of these 100 relics, because you're gonna get like a couple relics and hopefully you're gonna get a purple relic. and that will boost your CP by a lot. So I would definitely get one of these for sure. Because that's really useful. What else would I get? Under the other one that I really would get, let me see if I can find it. Because that I know that one's in a really weird spot. I would get yourself some inventory space. And weight. I wouldn't worry about weight as much, but I would worry about inventory space. Because you don't want to run out of inventory when you're AFK or asleep, you know? To get yourself better pets, what you do is you click on the top right corner, you go on pets, and then you click on the exchange. Right here you have info tab, and then you have exchange tab. And what you do is you combine the pets. You level up your pets, you know, your tier 1 pet to level 10, your second tier 1 pet to level 10, and then you combine the two tier 1 pets for a chance to combine them into a tier 2 pet. And then you keep doing that over and over and over. Until you have, you know, two of tier 2 pets, and then you can try to combine it for tier 3 pets. It's worth getting at least tier 2 pets if you don't want to put too much money. But here's personally what I would do. If you have a little bit extra cash on you, I would use $20. And I would get this. This is one of the best things you can get. If you want a tier 2 pet, where is it? There it is. Hunter's Essential Package. I would get that. Because if you buy it twice, which is going to be $10 and $10, you're automatically going to get a tier 2 pet. On top of it, because you bought the two packages, you're going to get two tier 1 pets. Which means if you're lucky, there's your second tier 2 pet. And right off the bat, under $20, you now have two tier 2 pets. You know, just comes down to a little bit of luck. If you are at 3.2k CP, I would farm at two places. This is where I would farm personally. Either Crone Castle, or I would go to South Medea, Abandoned Iron Mine. Why? Just because of a chance of getting an orange weapon drop for you. That's basically where I would go farm. Plus, the CP requirements are not high. That means you're going to kill the mobs fast. You're going to get pretty good loot. And you're going to get pretty good drops in this area. You're right. Tier 3 pets only get 5 seconds faster than a tier 2 pet. But the reason I went for all three tier three pets is because in original Black Desert, all my pets are tier 3, and I really wanted to have that tier 3. The other, if you have the money, and if you want to put money into this game to support it, the other good items that I personally say that will definitely boost your CP by a lot, and I bought it out, like out the wazoo, bought it out completely. Is the year ends upgrade pet chest. It's a little bit expensive, but buying three of these chests will get you really up there. Not only in CP levels, but also in gear. It will be year ends upgrade chest. I would say that is one of the best chests to buy. Yeah, that would be the chest to buy if you really want a good progress and you really want to get up there. You're right. Crown Castle entrance does have a couple of good spots. But the main thing I worry about or I focus on when I look at my farming spots is the loot levels. See the loot levels? Crown Castle has a slightly higher loot level. That means it's like 1%, 2% better loot in a way, but it's still 1 to 2% passive of better loot. So that's my only take on it, is that the loot levels like might be a difference of just 1-2%, but 1 or 2% could mean orange or no orange. But, you know, it's really weird. That's awesome. Yeah, I still have yet to see. I'm waiting for my first red. If I ever get my first red, I'll freak out, and I'm gonna have a good time with that. So. But yeah, let me read real quickly through everything to make sure I didn't miss anything. But yeah, I would farm in those two places if you're like around over 3,000 CP. Because if a Laverto drops for you, and if you already have a Laverto, you know, you can sell it. Boom, there's your 300 mil of silver right there. You're right now, you know, you're closer to getting that Kazarka bot out if it ever, you know, gets on the market. I'm just making sure I didn't miss any other chats. You're still using blue plus 8 accessories? Yeah. I went a little bit crazy with mine. I bought a couple of rings and I bought a belt with the extra black pearls they were offering when you put a little bit of money in and stuff like that. So I went and I got those two. I'm trying to get my yellow jewelry to plus 3 and plus 5. I want to get my yellow jewelry to plus 5. And that's when, like, because then I'm just never going to upgrade jewelry, and I'm going to be good until I get my orange, like, you know, pieces. Dude, that is pretty cheap. Actually, no, that's actually more expensive than our market. I think our market is cheaper than that. Oh, no, never mind. I was wrong. It's anywhere between 600 and 730 mil here. but guys, what I'm gonna do, because I don't want my wife to divorce me and to be really mad at me and stuff like that, I'm gonna move you guys over to somebody else's stream, if that's okay, so that way I can go on a walk with my wife, and I'll come back later tonight, and I'll start streaming again, because my wife really wants to go on that walk, and, you know, I gotta choose my wife over everything else. That is that's how you have a happy marriage. You choose your wife over video games, and that's a hard, hard choice, but you gotta do it. Because wife is number one. Thanks for the follow. Happy wife, happy life. That is definitely it. So let's see. Who's a nice player that actually is a NA player? Because I don't want to put you guys in a Russian. For a Russian player. Let's see here. Oh man, is nobody on right now? You know what? Let's do this. We're gonna make somebody happy who has only one viewer. I hope you guys stay for their stream. And stuff like that, and make him happy, you know? Make him the next ninja. So let's see, and I do want, is there anybody with a camera though? Trying to find somebody. Okay, we're gonna do this person right here. Unfortunately I gotta take care of some stuff real quickly. So, thanks again for watching. I'll try to be back, and I hope to see all of you back again. And I am more than happy to chat, talk, share tips, and everything with you guys. Oh, thanks. Look, I'm just me. That's the. Thank you for saying that. I'm just me. So, guys, see you guys. Raid! Ha ha ha.